How many black holes are there in our galaxy? How did the first stars form? How did the universe come to be? These are some of the questions that ESO's extremely large telescope, the ELT, seeks to answer. Set to start operating later this decade, the ELT will host a whole suite of high-tech instruments capable of matching its immense light-collecting abilities. Unique among them is MICADO, the super camera of the extremely large telescope. MICADO stands for Multi-AO Imaging Camera for Deep Observations. It will study exoplanets, distant galaxies and stars, and investigate black holes such as Sagittarius A star at the center of the Milky Way.
The ELT, the largest telescope in the world, will have fantastic capabilities in terms of collecting the light. But the best telescope in the world can only be as good as the instrument at its back end, which actually then detects the light and analyzes it. And MICADO is a camera simply built to make optimal use of the ELT.
MICADO is a 20-ton science machine, 6 meters high and roughly the size of a small house. It is designed and built by an international consortium with over 150 people from 6 different countries under the leadership of the Max Planck Institute for Extraterrestrial Physics in Germany.
Within the consortium, we are so many partners and everybody has over one portion of the instrument. And we will have to design everything that is complementary and working properly together. When we put it together, everything has to fit and work.
150 people in 6 countries working on this project. We're working for a telescope that's not yet there yet, and everyone in the project is used to building instruments for a telescope that already exists, and this is a very different way to work.
So in astronomy, it's always about building a prototype. Companies normally have the nice thing, they build a prototype and then they optimize it until they can sell it. We have to build a prototype and it has to work. And this is, I think, a very, very big challenge. That's why a lot of people with a lot of experience work on things like this.
MICADO uses an ultra-sensitive infrared camera with high-resolution imaging capabilities to investigate cosmic objects that are obscured by clouds of dust and gas. Unlike visible light, radiation in the infrared can pierce through the clouds and reveal what would otherwise be shrouded in darkness. The infrared light is captured and fine-tuned by the ELT's mirrors and then fed into MICADO through a secondary instrument that corrects the blurring effects of the Earth's atmosphere in real time. The whole process enables MICADO to obtain extremely sharp images.
MICADO will have these 3 components, the imaging, the spectrometer, and will also enable to make precise astrometry. For the imaging, the resolution will be about 10 times larger than what we have with current 10-meter telescopes. And so that means not only the ELT will be the biggest eye on the universe, but MICADO will make sure that it's going to be the sharpest eye on the universe.
If you think about the resolution of this instrument, if I told you it was 10 milliarc seconds, that doesn't mean anything. If I said we're here in Munich, if you could imagine looking at someone in Berlin 500 kilometers away and they held up their hand, you'd be able to resolve the width of their finger. This is how fine the resolution is.
After correction, the light passes into MICADO's ultra-cold heart, the chamber where its infrared detectors are housed. This cold chamber is around 2 meters in diameter and keeps the detectors at a frosty minus 200 degrees centigrade.
We're observing in the infrared, so we're detecting heat. And because we're detecting heat, we need to have all our optics and our detectors cooled right down so they detect the heat from the astronomical objects and not the heat from the instrument itself.
Only by keeping cool can MICADO sense even the faintest infrared signals. Its immense increase in sensitivity will enable astronomers to discover stars previously too dim to be detected, and to peer more closely at exoplanets previously hidden by their brighter stars.
MICADO will directly image exoplanets around a variety of stars nearby, and not only the more giant planets, but really go to twins of Earth planets.
Not only can MICADO see in the dark, it can also see with stunning clarity. The size of the ELT's primary mirror, 39 meters in diameter, allows it to obtain extremely high-resolution images. Thus, MICADO can tell individual stars in crowded clusters apart and reveal details in distant galaxies. At the center of our galaxy, MICADO will detect stars increasingly closer to Sagittarius A star.
This is one of the really exciting things, because the resolution of this instrument is so high, we can measure proper motions of stars very, very precisely, much better than any other telescope.
MICADO will be able to perform with the same sensitivity as the James Webb Space Telescope, but with 6 times the resolution. This will allow astronomers to capture ancient light from the very first stars, just as they began to shine, giving us hints about the origin of the universe.
James Webb will discover many very remote galaxies, for example, or very faint stars and galaxies nearby, but it will not be able to look at them in detail. And so with MICADO, we will go after those objects. And so the James Webb will tell us the when and the where, but we, with MICADO, will be able to tell the how.
We're thinking about things we know now. What's most exciting is the things we haven't thought of yet, the discoveries we'll make that we haven't anticipated.
It will open up a new space for discoveries that we may not even think of now. That happened to me in the past, luckily, and I hope that will be the case again.
The ELT super camera MICADO will become an invaluable tool to help us understand the cosmos. It will take us closer than ever before to the supermassive black hole at the heart of the Milky Way. It will give us a look at the first remote galaxies that formed after the Big Bang, and make us rethink our place in the universe.